Look in my eyes, what do you see? A YouTube list about CM Punk's backstage antics in AEW and his personality. Clashes with other talent. It's been one big week for one Bill Phil, with his AEW antics taking center stage like it's September 22 all over again. But this time it feels different. Dan Layton and I did a two-hour podcast about him this week, and the mood in the room of the live chat was... it was different. So let's talk about it. Here are five reasons why CM Punk should be fired from AEW and five why he shouldn't. If you don't want me to get fired, I'd press that subscribe button. Ollie Davis demands it. He should be fired because he's causing backstage issues, reportedly. While it's hard to ever truly know what's going on behind the scenes in a wrestling company, there seems to be two prevailing narratives. Number one, CM Punk is a locker room cancer, self-centered, fragile ego, stubborn, destructive personality destroying AEW within. Or number B, CM Punk is a locker room leader, helping young talent, business-orientated, driven, and seeing AEW continue to grow. While there are problem voices in the industry that would describe Punk as either A or B, the same can be said for the tribalistic wrestling fans of 2023, with the ones in Camp A being... really, really loud about it. Case in point, last weekend, and his out-the-blue shoot-style comments on Hangman Adam Page, the only member of the Elite Quartet that he's allowed to talk about. Reportedly, Punk regrets these comments and was just talking smack about Page and the Elite in order to facilitate an on-screen angle. But regardless of intent, it made news come out that several other names had actually been banned from coming to Collision, including Elite-friendly names like Ryan Nemeth and Matt Hardy, and even Head of Talent Relations Christopher Daniels. Now, it's never been said that it was CM Punk that banned these people, but the scuttlebutt is it was CM Punk that banned these people. And then there was a story in the week that he also had a heated or civil discussion, based on whoever you believe, with Jack Perry about his work ethic. But he shouldn't be fired because he's a draw. Now, as much as Punk's detractors would hate to admit it, the guy is one of, if not the biggest name in AEW. There really is nobody else you could justify giving an entire new show to than CM Punk. It's even been reported that Collision only got the green light because of Punk, in the same way that Fox agreed to air SmackDown because WWE promised they'd get Brock Lesnar and Ronda Rousey on the show, and why Roman Reigns remains on SmackDown to this day. Punk does move merch. Punk does sell tickets. He's been involved in marquee spots in the company's four highest grossing pay-per-view shows ever, and has gotten Dynamite over that 1 million viewer mark on multiple occasions, something it doesn't do very often. He also just has a massive understanding for the business and what it takes to create both compelling matches and long-term engaging stories, leading to better viewership, pay-per-view buys, and the like. Punk is most certainly a valuable asset from a business point of view. Heck, David Zaslav didn't bestow the One Bill Phil moniker on him willy-nilly. Without Punk, there wouldn't be a Collision, and there wouldn't be the big money for All Elite Wrestling and the rest of the talent that comes along with it. Tony knows it, Punk knows it. Unfortunately, that can be a scary amount of leverage for one man. But maybe he should be fired because... is he really a draw? While AEW was doing its biggest business on TV and pay-per-view throughout Punk's AEW honeymoon period between All Out 2021 and 2022, one could argue that the bloom may have come off the rose since his initial return. While Collision's viewership has been pretty solid for the most part, I think some expected more from the only show you can see the Second City Saint do the graps. Admittedly, that Saturday night time slot definitely isn't helping matters in Punk's defense. Stiff competition from other sports and, more devastatingly, SummerSlam really did hurt the idea that Punk is a ratings draw. Now, Tony Khan is infamously a numbers guy first, and only he will truly be able to know whether Punk's drawing power is worth all the extra baggage that comes with him. But if Punk's luster does begin to wear and all you're getting is negative press and backstage drama after you went to all the efforts to essentially create CM Punk's Saturday Night Slam, then maybe it's probably wise to cut ties, Tony. But he shouldn't be fired because he has a special aura like no one else. While many things can be disputed about Punk, he really is among a rare breed that just captivates people. Whether that's on the microphone, in the ring, hell, even on commentary, nobody can... oh, sorry, I think that's been played out by this point. But you get my point. Punk can outshine about 98% of pro wrestlers currently and historically in many regards. That aura he naturally carries with him It's hard to describe. Ironically, as someone who played a cult leader during his straight edge society days, Punk does have that kind of energy, which is why, love him or hate him, he always draws emotion. While all of this may come across a little bit like Michael Cole talking about 2010's John Cena, it's true. Why else do you think in the 7 years that he was away from the wrestling business, all anyone could ask was, where's CM Punk, like he's an actual real life Poochie? I know it's messy sometimes having him about, but it's kind of worth it for those moments, like when he was sat across from Malakai Black and the crowd went ape shit. He's just got it, man. But he should be fired because he's overshadowing good stuff like All In. As much as Punk antics are always the news story in the world of pro wrestling, it does not get exhausting seeing yet another YouTube video about CM Punk. Oh, I mean, yeah, I do see the irony here. Yeah, maybe we're just feeding the problem. Maybe I should be discussing something else. There's a ton of great wrestling out there and plenty to be excited about in AEW, WWE, and beyond. Most notably for AEW is, oh yeah, only the biggest wrestling event on Western shores of all freaking time on August 27th. All In is a truly momentous occasion for professional wrestling. If it was WWE, you'd bet your bottom dollar it would have been plugged to high heaven ad nauseum. AEW are just a week away from 80,000 people packing into Wembley Stadium for their first ever outside of North America pay-per-view. Yet, with one post-show promo that wasn't even on TV or canon, it just feels like a whole new can of worms has been opened up once again. This horrendous timing has become something of a habit in the year-long Punk Elite saga. Just when the company starts to take positive strides, Punk, it seems, sticks his foot in his mouth and the whole company takes many steps back. But he shouldn't be fired because he is getting people talking about AEW. Look, Punk's behavior does get tiring on fans and likely tons as well, at the very least when Punk is around, but AEW is more on the lips now than ever before. Bad press is better than no press after all, right? While that is debatable, as mentioned, Punk is a rare breed of performer that fans will follow, regardless of company, heck, regardless of sport. Just look at his time in UFC. The guy brought a ton of new eyes. Whether he won or lost, the fact that it was him made that fight must-see. That's why, as baffling as it seemed, splitting the roster to have Punk and his friends on Collision and the Elite and their friends is starting to seem like a shrewd move, albeit one that has serious long-term question marks. See, having Punk around, in whatever role, is always going to be better from a business and publicity standpoint than not having him there, because guess what? Wherever Punk ends up, he's going to take his fans with him. Yes, many of Punk's fans would watch AEW anyway, but the disillusioned fan, who perhaps was only brought back into wrestling because of Punk and his pipe bomb, may have only truly begun tuning into AEW because of Phil in the first place. So Tony knows that in order to ensure that those fans that fit that bill stay put and keep watching, you gotta keep Punk involved. But he should be fired because that talk reflects poorly on Tony Khan and AEW. 2022 All Out press conference truly was a moment in time, providing memorable quotes, a boatload of exposure for Mindy's Bakery in Chicago, and Tony Khan displaying every single human emotion in just under half an hour. The new Salcedo upload of that press conference has 1.7 million views on it. That's incredible. While the words coming out of Punk's mouth are still as jaw-dropping now as they were in September, both then and now, it's hard to not feel bad for Tony. It made him look powerless, like the everything is fine meme. Tony could only sit back and just watch the next 9 months flash before his eyes. While it sounds harsh, a Vince McMahon or a Triple H would never have let Punk do what he did, so this immediately reflects poorly upon Khan's leadership and authority. But the fact is, Punk should never have put Khan in such a spot in the first place. In fact, Punk has apologized for putting him in that position. Then, ever since that fateful day until June 17th when Punk re-emerged on TV, Khan was forced to hear questions about Punk, respond to reports, all while trying to run a business, contrary to what Punk said at the presser, and with the reports that Punk has the power to block people from coming to the building, you then have fans asking, who really is in charge around here? That's also not a good look for Tony, and it ain't a good look for AEW in a month where they've already had other bad press over the Lufisto comments. And even now with Punk back on our screens, this talk remains. The topic just shifts. Bottom line is, it's always usually in relation to Punk and what he said or what he's done. But you shouldn't fire him because, let's face it, we all want to see CM Punk versus Kenny Omega. As much as it seems unlikely right now in the wake of his anti-Hangman comments, I think it's safe to say that many of us still believe that eventually Punk and the Elite will work something out. They can at least like coexist, right? This is pro wrestling after all. If I had a nickel for how many times a so-called impossible occurrence happened in this wacky world, I'd have like, I don't know, $5 or something. We don't have nickels here and I don't know what they are. Are dollars even real currency? Even though the current reports suggest that Punk wants to feud but the Elite don't, there may, at the very least, be one man in the group who will, and that man is Kenny Omega. While the Bucks and Hangman don't seem keen, Omega and Punk reportedly did talk immediately following Brawl Out, with Punk supposedly having no beef with the Cleaner. Now, whether Omega feels the same following the latest development remains to be seen, however, it does seem marginally possible, even after the bad stuff that came from Brawl Out. I, as a wrestling fan who loves wrestling, start to fantasy book that stare down between Punk and Omega. I'm doing it right now. I pitched for them to do it all in on a podcast recently. And while that marginal possibility exists, I'm afraid you're just gonna have to keep them around, Tony. Ignore all of the shoulds on this list. Shh, close your ears. But you probably should fire him because it's exhausting talking about CM Punk. All right, I lied. Open your ears just one more time, because for fans, journalists, talent, everyone, endlessly talking about or hearing about what Punk has said or done this time is incredibly exhausting. So much so that I think some have tuned out. All the talk of will he come back, will he rip up his AEW contract, will he face the Elite, will he apologize, will he invite Hangman for a tea party? Unfortunately, the constant narrative surrounding Punk has naturally seen his stock fall in many eyes. People are exhausted. Look at the numbers on the WrestleTalk news videos about Brawl Out and look at the ones about the latest drama. It's night and day. Now, it's up for debate how much of this can be attributed to Punk himself and just how much of the finger points are wrestling journalism or how tired wrestling fans are about hearing about backstage antics. But however, due to Punk's status and controversial actions, we, like many others, have to talk about him. But everything and everyone has its limits, and you've just got to ask, when is enough enough and when's it time for a change? When does Punk fatigue drain every last fiber from our being where we physically cannot click on another Punk story or force ourselves to even tune into Collision, heaven forbid? And maybe some people are not far off. But he shouldn't be fired, because it's not nice to wish someone gets fired just so you can make a wrestling YouTube list. Plus, we'll still be talking about CM Punk even if he does leave. Look, for our last entry, I want to make it clear that nobody here at WrestleTalk or Parts of Unknown actually wishes for Punk to get the sack. That would be a crappy thing to do, especially all for the sake of a YouTube list. So no, as I conveyed in the shouldn't entries, I do think there are plenty of reasons to want Punk to stick around for fans, for talent, and for Tony Khan. Hopefully, the should entries on this list are just temporary issues and things do calm down again once and for all. We'll get the Elite versus CMFTR and everyone rides off into the sunset, neatly stacked on top of Hangman Page's horse like one big, warm, loving Jenga tower, counting their cash while we as wrestling fans get to enjoy a banging match. And do you know what? Even if AEW did let Punk go, we and everyone else will undoubtedly follow him to the ends of the earth and report every single last Instagram story he posts. So yeah, rest easy, Phil. We've come too far now to stop. CM Punk return confirmed, etc. Well, that's our list, and if you want something more WWE related with your list type activities, why not watch Peak Countdown, all the things that WWE did wrong with SummerSlam. Jam that summer jam.
SummerSlam 2023 was a fine show. It was fine, wasn't it? There were some good bits and there were some bad bits. It's probably the weakest Triple H-led premium live event yet, which doesn't mean it was necessarily terrible, just that the others were excellent. However, there were quite a few errors across the show that, fingers crossed, can be improved upon for future shows.